Hi, I'm Geddy Lee, and this is Alex Lifeson.
Yes, I'm Alex Lifeson.
We're going to talk and answer some questions that I think fans have written in on the interweb.
We'll give good answers for most of them.
And we'll be lying mostly.
Enjoy.
Working man for me. I love playing working man.
I don't know, natural science. You're talking about a Rush song, right?
Hemispheres? Wow, what year was that?
That was 79.
That was 79.
No, yeah. It was earlier.
And we were in England, so it was probably Hash.
78. Probably. Yeah.
Probably Hash.
And coffee.
I hope so. We don't have any immediate plans for that. Right now we're on holiday. I hope that once a new year rolls around and the juices get flowing and we get hungry to write, that we can talk about that.
Yeah, definitely.
Right, so the band's definitely not done by any means, right?
Not in my mind, mm-hmm. But I can't speak for everybody here.
Well, it just seemed like a good idea at the time. I had a speech written and I was trying to memorize it and I couldn't remember it. And I thought I might as well just blah, blah, blah. And I thought, well, that's a good idea. And so I thought I would tell a story about our history and how we got to that stage without using any words. And the interesting thing is that everybody remembers my speech.
The fact that it was in our hometown made it a bit more special. It was kind of full circle to our very first live album. The first thing that we came up with was this concept of reverse chronological order. Then we had to set about the arduous task of arguing about which songs would fit in that reverse chronological order. So I think the first version was about 4 hours long, and then we just kept cutting back. When I was really young, I was a Superman fan. And then I became a Green Lantern fan. I just liked the paraphernalia. It was cool. How about you?
Shemp? Was he a superhero?
Of sorts, he was, yeah. Ear, with a P in front of it and a T at the end. Peart.
Peart.
Are we going to tour again? That's a question that I'd like to know myself. I can't answer the question really because I have no idea, but it doesn't look good at this point. Not all of us agree on whether they want to tour again.
I'm sorry.
It's difficult because we all have a sort of different idea about touring. And we, at this moment, we are not all on the same page. Stairway to Heaven, Jimmy Page.
Yeah, that is a good one. That is a good one. Yeah. Oh, you know what? And the Immigrant Song too. That's a pretty awesome solo in there.
And what about Comfortably Numb?
See, it goes on and on and on. Oh.
It was my birthday, and we were playing a club in Toronto called the Piccadilly Tube back in, 73? And I was a little tipsy, and I fell off the stage.
Forward
into the crowd.
Yeah.
And they pushed me back on the stage.
And I remember that. For me, oh, I do remember when we were playing Texas Jam, so there were like a gazillion people at the gig. And we were playing, it was outdoors in the afternoon we were playing, and I did this little, cool, running backwards thing, and there was a little lip on the stage, and I caught the lip and then did smack on my ass, and I sat there on the stage playing, thinking, how am I gonna get up out of this position without looking, you know, horribly awkward? So I looked horribly awkward.
That's not fair.
Yeah, Kenny.
Yeah, Neil.
Some of my best friends like Star Wars, don't get me wrong. But Star Wars has magic in it. You know, it has the Force, and it's really about family conflicts, and it's Shakespearean. It's this nobility, essentially.